Hi everyone, this is Brendan here. So we finally made our way back to top 200 on the global leaderboard. I just want to show you guys some of the raids that made it possible. So this is a defense raid that has happened to my base. So for this particular attack itself, actually this was my decoy base as it was my fake base. But however, I accidentally just let it go on defend. I didn't come online to change my base as I was going for auto defend, as this happened was in the afternoon when I was not free to clash. So I just basically let my account go for auto defend, not even clouding for even a single minute. So then this raid occurred where this guy used the golems and also P.e.k.k.s. So basically dropping his king and queen at the wrong position, and also his second jump spell was put at the wrong place. As you can see, no troops are going for the jump spell itself, and the P.e.k.k. has gone down. Now left with only his king, queen, and also the top right, there's one more P.e.k.k. being shot by my X-Bow. So as you can see, the percentage isn't good. And now when the wall breaks, my CC is going to come out, which contains 35 archers. So now 35 archers are going to come out and distract the king and queen. So he's going to have a really big trouble trying to even take out some of the defenses, as now he dropped his lightning spell, which technically I feel that is a wrong placement, as he should have dropped it maybe to the right a bit more to take out the archers. So now just left his queen. Queen going to go down in her ability mode, has gone down, unable to take out the town hall. So this raid was a very bad raid for him, but it was a good raid for me, as you can see, this was definitely going to be a win for me. Now trying to salvage the situation, dropping a minion, trying to lure my archers to the left side. Probably left with his wizards to try to take some percentages, but the way he deployed wasn't too good, as the wizards gone down really really quickly by the cannons. So that's it, first defense win. So now the second defense, I changed back to my original base. So this guy was using a lava lumens. So basically he dropped it on the bottom left, where my queen actually is on the top right. I'm changing my base a bit so to like confuse people around, especially those people who are like sandboxing my base to try to test out the defenses, this and that. So my CC has came out, 35 archers has come out to play a fool with the troops. So the minions are all distracted by it. The skeleton traps also came out to do more damage to the balloons. Balloons not being able to do a lot of damage to my infernos. And if you notice, the infernos are set way apart from the town hall, unable to do any splash damage to my town hall. So now there's a very big group of skeleton traps on the top left, and also the archers. So now coming towards the dragon, which is left over there, trying to take out some of the structures, getting more percentages. However, the air defenses has already targeted the dragon, and now the dragon has gone down. So looking at the situation, he is also a little bit of a trouble. If I'm him, I'll be really really worried itself, as I don't know whether I can get the percentage, because the king and queen, they will definitely get distracted by the troops. So now dropping his king, going in, and then after that dropping a few more wall breakers. I don't think his wall breaker was dropped properly, as the mortar actually took out the wall breakers. So wasn't a good deployment in my opinion. So then deploying more of the troops to try to take out the structures on the top. So he's now left with only his queen. So let's see what's he gonna do about it. So looking at the situation, he dropped the queen on the top left again where the king was. I don't think that was a good placement in my opinion. So now cloaking up the queen. And then there was a giant bomb. The queen just left with only one dot of blood. The inferno took just one blast and it gone down. So this was another defense win for me, scoring me against a king's rock. So now this is the third defense against this Russian clan. Not every day is Sunday, like what I always say. So this defense itself was actually a loss. So as you can see, he's using the golems and double jump strategy again. In my CC itself, I had a lava and also a balloon, as I didn't request for 35 archers. I was a little lazy this time, just testing out, see whether this this CC was good for defense, but we will see as how it goes. So now dropping his other troops, more king and queen going in, and also raging up his troops, two P.e.k.k.s going in. So the P.e.k.k.s, one of them is already at red blood, being taken out by the Tesla, so almost going down. Now has just gone down. Second P.e.k.k. has just gone in, and then now raging up also. So going all the way in into my core, and then after that the queen is over there just doing a lot of damage over there. So king has gone up, taking more of the structures, percentage is scoring a lot for him. Town hall has already been targeted, almost going to go down. So just raging up his king, dealing more damage on the top. So as you can see, this was a rather easy, almost going to be 2-star for him, as my CC itself was a lava and also a balloon, which is not the usual CC defense troop that I always use. So this is something also I would definitely not use again. So now let's look at my attack. So this is the first attack against Quantum Air. So when I looked at the name, I was like, Quantum Air, maybe this clan was using air for all their attacks. So maybe everybody is very good in air. So I might have to go over there to learn from them whatsoever if they allow me to go in to say hi. As you can see, so I'm using my Lava Lumians to attack. My same deployment strategy. As mentioned, this base, I really, really hate this base a lot. So deploying my troops in that particular manner, clearing more of the structures on the left side, freezing up the left inferno, and now just taking up more of the structures. And the left side, there's a lot of free buildings to take. My minions and my pups are going for it, which is a really, really good thing. And now the balloons have gone down, just left with the structures to take out. I didn't want to drop my king and queen at this point of time, just checking for where the barbarian would go. So dropping a barbarian, looking at where it go, now dropping my wall breaker to do some damage to the wall first so that my troops will actually go in. So dropping more troops to check where my king and queen will go. So this is the reason why I have extra troops with me, especially wall breakers. So now my king has gone in, now being distracted by the skeletons. I'll reach him up right now. That's a good thing. So then after that, just continue destroying more of the defenses. Once everything is down, just queen targeting the town hall, because there's a wall protecting over there. The BK will never ever go for the town hall, and cloaking her right now. And then after that, just continuing to get more percentages and scoring a 71% against this base. So the second attack is against I'm not sure, no clan this base, this guy. So this is the first time I attacked this base. I think it was like turn 180 degrees, so it was a little confusing for me. So never mind, I'll just continue attack. So deploying in the same manner, lava is going for the air defense and then being mid shield for the balloons. The queen was rather far away. I mean, for me, when I usually attack, I'll go for the queen and one air inferno at a time, so that my balloons do not get taken down by the infernos as quickly, and so I'll be able to take out the queen. However, this time I decided to go from the other side, so that I can clear more of the structures, because I noticed that the top left, the structures there were a lot of wizard towers, afraid that my balloons will actually get taken out by them, so I didn't want to go there. So now looking at the situation, I was thinking how to get to the town hall is really, really far in. So then I deployed some of my troops, trying to check where they will actually walk to. So the CC came out of balloon, and then I used my barbarian to try to lure them to the side there, using my archers. So then after that, I drop a minion. The good thing about using minions against this kind of CC troops, especially the skeletons, is that they won't ever attack you, because they only can attack ground troops. Especially for balloons, they also can only attack ground troops. That's why minions are really important, even in farming. That's why I usually advise people to bring at least 5 minions, because once you have a minion and then you drop like on a cannon or a mortar, they basically can't do anything to the minion, and they will just take it out without having to waste any more troops. So now the queen is targeting the town hall, it's almost going to go down. And then after that, the king is just banging the wall over there, I don't know what was he doing. So then the town hall's gone down and getting us that win. So yeah, that's it for this raid. After all those defenses and attack wins, and after pushing for roughly 1 month, we have reached 4,540 trophies from the very bottom of the clan to reaching the top 3 in the clan in Mega Empire Asia. So currently this is the global leaderboard, being at 182 with that number of trophies. As you can see, everybody is still pushing a lot, and it's really, really hard to push in trophies, as the bases just do not really come up for you to even attack. So that's it for the series of pushing to leaders board. We have made our way to top 200 on the global leaderboard. But not to worry, I'll still be pushing my trophies, maybe push to 4,006 or even 4,007, hopefully be able to reach maybe top 50 or top 20 in the world. I don't think I'll be able to reach top in the world, because it's really, really just too difficult. And also, I will be making more contents on Clan War, also making more farming videos, especially on my sub account, because I've been focusing a lot on this account to update you guys on my progress. So don't worry, I'll still be making my farming videos, also to teach you guys how to farm in the best and optimal manner using BAM, and also other stuff such as I'll be talking more on defenses, and also other miscellaneous stuff on Clash, as to how to improve your raids, improve your farming, and improve your clan wars. So do take note, and also do catch up for the next video that I'm going to upload. That's going to be very, very interesting. So do check it out. So with that said, I'd like to thank you for watching my video, and clash on.